Hello students, welcome back to the online classes of social studies. Let's continue chapter 1 of geography, the earth and the solar system. Till now we have learnt about the sun and the stars, the universe, nebula, what are stars, what is constellation, galaxy, planets, sun, solar system, all eight planets and their features. Today we will learn about other celestial bodies. Moon. These are satellites of planets. Like planets are moving around the sun, satellites are moving around the planets. And they revolve around planet in their own orbit. Like the planets have their own path to move around the sun, satellites also have their own orbit or own path to move around each planet. And almost all the planets have their satellites. Mercury and Venus are the only planet which do not have any moons around them. There are other satellites also. These moons are actually the natural satellite. There are also some man-made satellites which are sent into the orbit around the earth. Such satellites are called artificial satellites. Okay, so this was about moon. Moons are natural satellite moving around the planets. Other than the natural satellite, there are man-made or artificial satellites which are placed into the orbit of the earth or the planets to have some other information, like we have weather forecasting satellites and so many other. Okay, Earth's moon, a natural satellite of the earth. It has a diameter which is nearly 1/4 of earth's diameter. It appears very big or nearly as large as the sun, as it is much closer to the earth in comparison to the sun. So, moon is a natural satellite of the earth. Its diameter is nearly 1/4 of the earth and looks almost big like sun. Why? Because it is very close to the earth. It is about 384,000 km from the earth, and the moon rotates around the sun in 27 days and 8 hours, and it is also taking the same time to spin on its axis. So, like Earth is revolving around the sun in 365 days and 6 hours. The moon is moving around the earth in 27 days and 8 hours. And it is taking the same time for rotating on its own axis. It is because of this that the same side of the moon is visible from the earth at all times. Because the moon is taking same time for rotation and revolution, 27 days and 8 hours, that's why we see the same face of the moon. It has no light of its own but appears to shine because it reflects the light of sun falling on it. So moon or satellite doesn't have its own light. They get the heat and light from the stars. So the earth's moon that we see seems to be brightening and lighted up. That is because of the light of the sun. There is no life on moon. Life is not possible there because moon has no atmosphere. And when there is no atmosphere, layer of air, there will be no clouds, no rain, no wind. Okay, and the surface of the moon is open and rough with lots of ups and downs that we can see sometimes at night, the bright patches. And sound also cannot travel on the moon. Okay. Asteroids. Asteroids are small rocky celestial bodies moving around the sun between the orbit of Mars and Jupiter. When we were learning about the inner planet and outer planet, I had told you after the first four planets, that is Mercury, Venus, Mars and Earth, there are what we say a belt of asteroids. So between the planet of Mars and Jupiter, there is a belt of asteroids. They are rocks साइंटिस्ट बिलीव दैट दे आर रिमेन्स ऑफ द प्लैनेट विच एक्सप्लोरेड मेनी ईयर्स अगो. सो साइंटिस्ट बिलीव दैट एस्टेरॉइड्स आर ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द प्लैनेट्स. There was a big bang theory. A bang was there. A blast was there from where the planets were formed, and some rocks were left, which became as asteroids. So scientists believe that the remains of planet, remaining part of the planets are only, planets are only known as asteroids. Meteors. They are small rocky pieces which float freely around the sun in outer space. Sometimes they come close to Earth's space surface while they enter the Earth's atmosphere. The friction with the atmosphere causes them to heat up and they burn up. On occasions when the meteoroids do not burn and completely, they fall on Earth and create a hollow on Earth's surface. So meteors are also rocky pieces which are moving around the sun, and they are entering the Earth's atmosphere because of the friction caused by the atmosphere. And sometimes they do not burn up and they hit the Earth's surface, causing lots of hollows on the Earth's surface. Comets. Comets are visible from Earth on rare occasions. These are type of asteroid, but unlike asteroid, they are far away in outer space beyond the planets. So comets are also visible from the Earth on some occasions. They are also type of asteroid, types of rocks, but unlike asteroid, they are far away in outer space. They are far away beyond the planets, far away from the planets. Whereas the asteroids are close to the planets. They have a long shining tail which is formed by the clumps of ice, gas and dust. And these rocky pieces of comets have a tail made up of ice, gas and dust. Halley Comet is one of the comets which was seen in 1986 and which will be visible after 76 years. Okay, so Halley Comet was seen in 1986. Now it will be seen after 76 years. That means when it will be seen, add it. It will be seen in 2062. In India, it is also known as Pucchal Tara or a star with a tail. There are other comets also may be visible at different time. So comets are also rocky pieces moving in the space far away from the planets, and they have a tail made up of clouds and gases, the ice, gas and dust. And sometimes they appear in many years, they appear in the sky, like the Halley Comet was visible in 1986. Now it will be visible in 2062. In India, it is also known as Pucchal Tara. So children, we have completed about the chapter 1, the Earth and the star or the solar system. Today, I am giving you some exercises also. Do it in your books. And tomorrow, we will continue with the question answers. Thank you.